talking about the ghetto. Funky, funky, get out. Trying to survive, trying to stay alive.
Again, black at your ass again, and we back for another one. But first, we would like you to subscribe to the Reaper, because we doing good things and bringing good messages here at Reaper. And go to my website, jazzbotareaper.com, and support your main nigga on the trigger. Happy Thanksgiving to all of you people out there. The Reaper is not going to be a hater, but the Reaper don't celebrate Thanksgiving, you know, like the traditional people do with a big feast or whatever, but I enjoy the time off, and I don't hate on nobody that do, because, you know, this is what you like to do, and you can't stop people from, you know, what they like to do. But what I want to talk about is getting to the topic today, mind control. Do people use it to control other people? Because this is what I see in our society today, whether it's with your job, you know, some people want to control everything you do, even on your time off, you know, with your job. And in a relationship, you know, some woman is man is always wanting to change you, you know, and, you know, in religion, you know, the pastor is telling you you're going to hell if you don't do what the Bible say or pay your tithes or whatever. And education, you know, colleges sell education like churches, you know, sell game, because game is sold and not, you know, told. And with the holidays, they say that, you know, Jesus was born on Christmas, and Easter is the Passover. So we gonna go through some of these things and talk about them today because, you know, the Reaper see that, you know, a lot of people is just being mind controlled and, you know, and people like to control people, whether it's in a job, relationship, or with religion, or, you know, with the holidays, or with education, and we gonna go through some of these things, you know, like the Reaper said, jobs. Some jobs, you know, want to control everything you do, you know, even on your time off, and if they can't, you're not a good employee, and you could be doing everything correct at the job better than other employees. Is this mind control to get you, you know, to do more, an unfair treatment to make you think, you know, you're not doing enough? And, you know, some jobs make you, you know, people think they're balling out of control because they got a good job or whatever, or they're better than someone else. And in relationship, you know, some woman or man is always wanting to change you, who you are. You know, I'm not talking about, you know, habits, you know, bad habits or respect. That's for some of you tipping niggas, the Rebaby 1000, drinking or smoking or smoking too much weed or coming in late at night or, you know, ladies clubbing or spending money or hanging out with your girlfriends. You know, I'm not talking about, you know, those bad habits or, you know, or respects. I'm talking about, you know, career, you know, when you start working and, you know, they be bragging on, you know, what type of job you got and how you working or whatever, you know, and then when you get with them, you're not spending enough time with me, and you may not be an affectionate person or whatever, but you know, they try to change you and whip you down, and you know, having you telling them you love them lest they don't feel adequate enough or whatever. Or you could be a family oriented person, you know, you like to hang around your family and be around family or whatever. Or with chivalry, they want you to be bringing them flowers, you know, or something like that. Or you could be just a homebody, you know, so no, who you're, you know, marrying or who you're getting into a relationship. And the Reaper contends, just be satisfied with them and don't create a problem if it's not a problem. The Reaper keep it 1000. Don't try to mind control them or whatever, you know. And some of you women, you know, you be building up inadequate men, you know, saying they doing stuff for you and you know they not doing stuff for you, you know, to make other people, you know, feel better about your relationship. So you're trying to mind control them, and then you're trying to mind control the man, you know, to make him feel like, you know, he's doing something that he's not. Or, you know, some of you niggas be bragging on what kind of woman you got, and you don't have that type of woman or that type of love, but, you know, you're just trying to manipulate and mind control people like you do, and act like your relationship is perfect. And then in religion, you know, the pastor is always telling you, you know, you're going to hell, you know, if you don't do what the Bible says. And he's, you know, robbing you. And some of you even, you know, they be even trying to, you know, get between your legs, and people in the church or religion will try to control you or your whole family if they can, you know, or if they think they know more, you know, about the Bible than you do, you know. But they never tell you this, what the Reaper is saying, you know, it is impossible to do everything in the Bible, and a lot of it is unproven, the real keep it 1000. And they aren't doing everything that they say they do in the Bible, but people love to control other people, the minds of people, and, you know, to have power over them, the Reaper keep it 1000. And this is what, you know, people do with this mind control thing. And then with educations, you know, colleges sell educations like churches, you know, because game is sold and not told. You know, they tell you, you know, the more educated you are, you know, the better you are. You better than the average person or whatever. But they don't teach entrepreneurship too much. They sell the American dream, which is debt, which is career is debt, you know, college is debt, you know, a house is debt, you know. So they sell all this to make you a good debt slave, you know. But most people end up, you know, not working in what they went to school for, or working in, you know, they become a working class debt slave. No entrepreneurship, you know, or anything, you you know, but most people that come over to this country, you know, I mean, they don't speak no English, you know, and they open up businesses. You see them in your hood, Arabs, Asians, you know, Mexicans or whatever, you know, so there's this a mind control thing to make you feel like, you know, you're smarter than somebody else or whatever, when they don't really give you the tools to be an entrepreneur. They give you the tools to be a good debt slave. And do you really need all of this, you know, to open up a business or whatever? Maybe you could go to a trade school, or maybe you could save your money. I mean, a lot of these people is coming from other countries and opening up businesses right in your hood, and that's what black people used to do. A lot of black people in the 40s, 50s, and 60s wasn't college educated or whatever, but they still had a business, whether it was a corner store, a restaurant, or something of that nature, or a rib shack or something, you know, the Reaper Keep It 1000, or a pool hall or whatever, you know, and these people didn't have educations or whatever, you know, so is that, you know, a mind control thing to get you to go to college or whatever and spend money? The Reaper is not saying that you shouldn't, but, you know, I mean, it doesn't make you smarter than anyone else, you know. So, but they sell this in the American dream, you know, to make you come there because they get money on student loans and everything. And holidays, you know, Jesus was born, you know, on Christmas, and Easter is the Passover, and Thanksgiving is a time to give thanks, to be thankful. And, you know, a time to spend with friends and family, all orchestrated, you know, by churches and schools, you know, to get your money and to control your mind. The Reaper Keep It 1000. And by the power structure to make merchants rich. You know, I see excuses people make to spend money on and celebrate the holidays. You know, number one, it says to get together with family and friends. You know, number two, can't we just have a meal? Number three, my kids is going to miss out and feel left out. But, you know, somebody is mind controlling your kids, or if you know somebody is manipulating them, you will say, I don't care what they do in their household, don't listen to them, and this is what I do in mine. But when it come to holidays, you'll say that, you know, they gonna feel left out or whatever. But are you a failure, you know, if you don't do some of these things? Now, I like to get to the lady that rides with me, the lady that keeps it 1,000, sweet and sassy. Sassy, you heard the Reaper go over some of these things, and what do you think about it? Do you think that, you know, mind control, people love to mind control people, you know, I mean, and love to get them to do things, you know, just because they're doing them, or to get them to do wrong things?
Yeah, I do. I believe that people have to, you know, do that, the saying of you have to stand for something so you don't fall for anything. And to stand for something, you have to know who you are and know what you're getting into and know really what you're believing in order to make decisions of what's best for you or what's best for your children, or, you know, just what's right or wrong. I don't think you have to go to college in order for you to open up a business, because people go to college every day and they don't have nothing. They might be working the same type of job as you or something beneath you, and you didn't go to college. So as far as believing in what you have to do for the holidays and everything like that, you got to have your own mind, and you have to know what the things that you think everybody else is believing in is really about, to see if that's the best for you. You can't let nobody control you and make you feel like you have to do certain things. You have to do what fits your lifestyle. Some people fall for that, and they got to keep up with the Joneses, and I got to go to college, and I got to celebrate Christmas, and I got to do all this stuff. But is it really, you know, what works for you, or is it just what works for your family members or your friends or the people that are on the outside looking in trying to tell you what you need to do?
Yeah, you know, the Reaper see a lot of mind control things. It's like people, you know, I mean, you know, it's like they, you know, they get happy with naked mind control, you know, people or whatever. You know, I see it, you know, on a job or whatever, you know, when people will say, come over here and work this job or that job or whatever, you know, and their job is so much better than the job you got, and it's so much, you know, more compatible with you or them. You know, the supervisors and managers are so much more understanding, and they get raises or whatever, and they get you over there, and you'll find out they got bullshit over there just like you got at your job. The Reaper keep it 1,000, but they try to mind control you like they doing it, like, you know, balling out of control or whatever, or if they got a job or a house or whatever, you know, they try to make it seem like, you know, they're better than the average person that's working, but you're punching a clock just like that person is, and, you know, you live in check to check, and too many missed checks, you know, you will be homeless too. And then in relationship, I see it where people is trying to, you know, make their relationship seem like it's better and bigger than somebody else's, you know, or, you know, they're trying to control their mate, you know, trying to change them or whatever, you know, saying that the person is not affectionate enough, or, you know, hey, they're too family oriented, or you should bring me flowers, or, you know, just be satisfied with who you got. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. Because if that person is not that way, most of the time when they get too old, you can't change them anyway. They're just changing to try to please you. And in religion, I really see it, where the pastor be running around, you know, telling everybody they're going to hell, and he knows what happens in the afterlife, and he's never been, and, you know, he's robbing you all the time. And, you know, I see the deacons and people in, you know, in the church or whatever that think they know more about the Bible than you do. You know, they'd be happy with mind controlling you. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And soon as you learn something about the Bible, or you learn that they're mind controlling you, you know, they don't want to have anything to do with you. But long as you don't know nothing, they want to have something to do with you. And this is what they won't tell you. It's impossible, you know, in today's day and time to do everything in that Bible, you know, and a lot of it is unproven, but they won't tell you that, you know, but they know so much about the Bible, but they won't tell you that because they love to mind control you. You know, Reaper keep it 1,000. And then I just see it in the holidays with what everybody's doing, you know, or whatever, you know, people will say that you're miserable if you don't celebrate it, or my kids is missing out on something, or can't we have a meal, or can't we do this, that, and the other, you know, just say you like to celebrate it. You know, I like to celebrate the holidays, and you know, I'm not changing, you know, even though, you know, it's mind control or whatever, and manipulation to get you to spend money or whatever, you know, you'll still do it anyway, and you'll say your kids is missing out or whatever. But I contend, you know, if the dope man was trying to teach your kids that they're going to be successful, you know, selling dope, you would tell them, no, you're not, and stay away from that. And you would miss out, you know, whether your kid was just working at a job or whatever, because you know that the dope man is trying to mind control them or whatever. Or you always say to your kids or whatever, you know, I've heard some of you say, I don't care what they doing in their house or what their parents is doing, you know, I'm gonna do what I want to do in my house because their parents is doing something wrong. But when it comes to the holidays or whatever, you know, you people will say that your kids is missing out on something, and oh, and this is what they sell because they want you to spend money or whatever. You know, is there anything you want to add on this, Sweet and Sassy?
Well, just like I was saying before, you need to be an individual and know who you are and stop following behind other people and what other people think you should be doing or how you should be feeling or how you should be acting, because nobody knows yourself better than you, and it's only you can make decisions for your life and what's going on with you, because behind somebody else you can be brought harm, you can be put in debt. You can do all kind of stupid stuff because you're listening to the next person. You have to do what works for you, and you have to have your own mind.
Yeah, that's what people normally do. They normally want to do things that they see on TV. You know, that's what's, you know, raising the kids or what people do on social media. They want to do just like the chicken sandwich or whatever. Everybody had to have a Popeye's chicken sandwich and they caused a lot of mayhem and chaos. And, you know, people got shot or whatever, you know, just running down there trying to get a chicken sandwich or whatever. And I didn't think a chicken sandwich was that popular. The real chicken sandwich was, you know, a drumstick and some hot sauce on a piece of white bread. 1,000. That's what the chicken sandwich that I grew up on, you know, that was hot odd degrees. I mean, what is this at Popeye's, you know, when it makes that chicken sandwich better than the chicken sandwich that I grew up on? Because your mama or your grandmother knew how to cook that chicken real good, and you get you a piece of white bread and some hot sauce and put that drumstick, you know, in between the white bread and hot sauce, and you know, you go ahead and eat it up. But it was pandemonium when everybody wanted to get a chicken sandwich or whatever, you know, just like in education, you know, you see your Mexicans and your Arabs and, you know, your Asians opening up businesses in your hood with no college degree. Hell, they can't even, you know, speak English, and, you know, they passing you up, you know, is this mind control and are you being educated, you know, the right way is to be an entrepreneur and, you know, save your money or whatever. And people want to, you know, they want to buy houses and cars and everything else because they think that, you know, they're living the American dream. And the Reaper always contends a nightmare is a dream if you get it too early and you don't get it, you know, the way you should get it, you know. And a lot of people is putting the cart before the horse and getting in debt, you know, with everything. And then, you know, you can't see your way out of debt, so you're stuck to the job. And, you know, you don't create no wealth or anything for your family, and you may not be even creating anything, you know, for yourself, because most people, you know, leave a will instead of a bill, you know. I mean they leave a bill instead of a will, you know. Reaper, keep it 1,000, because most people, you know, die in debt or whatever. Now, we would like to get to the segment of Sassy's Trending Topics. But first, the Reaper want to go through some things, you know. We would like you, you know, to buy some of our merchandise, because the Reaper, you know, has some merchandise, and I got it in all different colors, you know. I mean, it's got, we don't give a fuck about the haters, you know, with the Reaper symbol, and we got them in, you know, fluorescent. We got them in black, you know. We got them in white, of course, you know, Reaper symbols and everything. And, you know, we got them in blue, of course. The Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, it says, we do not give a fuck about, you know, you hate us, you know, because you shouldn't care about a hater. Because a hater just wants to see you miserable. They want to talk behind your back. They want to keep you down. You know, they don't want to see you rise up like cream to the top, you know, and have, you know, the cream of the cup. They don't want to see you have nothing. So why should you give a fuck about what a hater think? And they come in all different shapes and sizes and colors, you know. They even come when they're really good lovers. The Reaper keep it 1,000. But, you know, we got Reaper here and, you know, black. You see the Reaper wear that with the symbol on the back. And, of course, we got them in the Reaper white, you know. And we got them even in the blue, you know. Reaper, you know, because we keep it rough, we keep it raw, we keep it real. We got them in red, Reaper, you know, and we got them in orange, you know, Reaper. So make sure you know, contact your boy, you know, or go to JazzboTheReaper.com and support your main nigga on the trigger, or make sure you contact your boy through Instant Messenger or whatever, and, you know, I will direct you, you know, how to get the Reaper merchandise. And we even got the bracelets or whatever, you know, the Reaper is representing, and we got the hoodies, you know, with Reaper on them and everything like that, you know. Now, I like to get to the lady that rides with me, the lady that keeps it 1,000, sweet and sassy. What you got on those hot trending topics, you know, today here for the Reaper?
Okay, we'll do our celebrity news and start off with Bill Cosby.
Bill Cosby.
He has broken his silence from behind bars. Not only is he not showing any remorse for his actions, but describes his cell in prison as a penthouse. He granted an interview at his new home, SCI Phoenix Penitentiary near Philadelphia, where he's serving 3 to 10 years for sexual assault charges. Cosby says the trial was a sham and unfair. All set up, they were all imposters. A woman in the jury stated he's guilty, we can all just go home. He says attorneys say it was a payoff. He says he's privileged in prison, his cell is a penthouse. He says he's innocent of all charges, but his conviction is a real racial issue.
I believe it is. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000 because, you know, these women didn't have no police reports. You know, all the charges, you know, mostly was 40, 50 years ago with no police reports and no evidence, just hearsay, and trying to convict Bill Cosby in, you know, the media and in public. The Reaper keep it 1,000. So, you know, why should he act like, you know, he's a guilty man when he is an innocent man? And, you know, Bill Cosby's penis ain't worked in 20 years. He's about 89 or some shit, you know. So how could he rape a woman, you know, 5 to 7 or 10 years ago even? The Reaper keep it 1,000. This is ludicrous. And these women, you know, doing this because they, Bill Cosby had a lot of money and they thought he was going to make them a celebrity or a star. And they slept with him. And then when they got to be older, you see that, you know, people will jump on bandwagons for money. You know, I mean, if they went and got, you know, some people's ex-lovers or whatever, and they put them in jail and they wanted them to squeal on them, a lot of people would do it for money and for fame. And, you know, this is what's happening, you know, in some of the R. Kelly trial. You know, I don't believe they got no current evidence on, you know, Robert or whatever, but I believe that, you know, if you start looking at someone's past and, you know, with no police reports or whatever, you know, there will be people that will roll over on you and squeal on you, just like the Savage chick. You know, she said that R. Kelly did nothing wrong to her. She's went around the United States, even when he wasn't with her, saying this. When they interviewed her, several police agencies and agents done interviewed her. No, he's not doing anything to me. My parents is out for money, and I'm not with that, and I'm gonna be with him because he's nice to me, and he's doing nothing improper to me. Now that they done locked him up, he's doing everything up under the sun to her because she's looking for money and he can't get to his money, you know, to, you know, make her feel satisfied. So people will do things for money and do everything and immoral acts or whatever, you know, because they want to do them or they think you're going to make, you know, them a celebrity or for money. And then when someone gets locked up, you know, they start to think for themselves or whatever, and they start to tell lies and roll over on these people. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Jay-Z.
Jay-Z, Jiggle.
He has a problem with an Australian book company using his name and lyrics to sell books. And now he's suing an Australian online book retailer called Little Homie. They're engaging in misleading and deceptive conduct to hawk a children's book titled AB to Jay-Z. In the suit, Jay claims Little Homie is infringing on his copyright and in lyrics for his from his hit single 99 Problems. The back cover reads, "If you're having problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but my ABCs ain't one." Jay-Z's legal team fired off a cease and desist to Little Homie in 2018, but the retailer kept deliberately using his lyrics. Jay filed a lawsuit in Australian federal court. The book is currently still for sale.
If you're having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. You know, that's the song Jay-Z had out, but they just said, I got 99 problems, but my ABCs ain't one. Jay-Z should sue them because, you know, they're getting money off of, you know, the catchphrase that he made up, you know, on that album. That's plain, you know, that's plain to see. And they didn't contact him. And, you know, some of his representatives done contacted them, and they still continue to do it and make money, you know, off of, you know, the rap lyric that Jay-Z made up, you know, the Reaper Keep It 1000. So I think he does have a case, you know. But, you know, I don't know, you know, I think he's, you know, he say he got 99 problems, you know, but a bitch ain't one. But if Beyonce divorced that nigga, she gonna take half of everything. The Reaper Keep It 1000, you know, because a woman can be a problem. So you better have a prenup, Jay, because if she ever divorce you with them two kids, you gonna see you got 99 problems, and the bitch is the main one. The Reaper Keep It 1000. Just like some of you niggas, you know. Your woman is the main one. Because some of you, you know, you don't put nothing on your penis. And, you know, she end up getting pregnant or whatever. Because you had your tipping shoes on. And, you know, you have 99 problems. And a bitch be the main one because you didn't put nothing on, you didn't put nothing on your penis. What else you got?
Okay, you go to my knee.
They call that a fuck nigga. What else you got? Happy Thanksgiving. You know, I hope some of you niggas, you know, you don't get drunk or whatever. And tonight, you put on your tipping shoes and you don't put nothing on your penis. Because you know you got a side chick out there, and you know, when you gonna be trying to make runs to the store and stay gold for 4 hours, and you know, you don't put nothing on your penis. So make sure you put something on your penis tonight. You know, don't get to drinking that Hennessy or whatever you drinking. And, you know, have unsafe sex because it's not good for the kids or the family. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Monique.
Monique.
She is facing more financial troubles over unpaid taxes amid her legal battle with Netflix. Georgia Department of Revenue slapped her and her husband, Sydney, with a state tax lien. She owed $12,165 from 2017, and if not paid soon, they are coming after her property and assets. Monique has had financial issues the past few years, but she's now at a total of $633.157. And if she doesn't come up with this money, they're going to take everything that she has.
You know, Monique got 99 problems, and that nigga is her main one, the Reaper Keep It 1000, Sydney, because Monique done went downhill ever since she got with Sydney, and he started managing her affairs, the Reaper Keep It 1000. So, you know, I mean, she's listening to Sydney, and, you know, he doesn't have no managerial background or whatever, you know, I mean, and, you know, it's like Monique's career, you know, has took a dive. I want to know what some of you women, you know, you're always saying you have financial difficulty of paying this and paying that and paying this, that, the other, but you never get rid of your nigga, the Reaper Keep. He be right there, you know, or she be right there, you know, you never, you know, get rid of your women, or, you know, you get rid of your nigga, you know, that may be causing you to have financial difficulty or whatever, you know, you keep that and you keep on moving on. And, you know, I ain't saying that people can't be in relationship, but, you know, if the dude ain't pulling his half, or he's not paying nothing, or he's living off of you and causing you to have financial difficulty, you know, you need to reevaluate who you with, the Reaper Keep It 1000, because, you know, I'm just saying that, you know, you be living there, the dude be living there with you, and he don't want to pay no bills, he don't want to work right, or whatever, and then, you know, you say you cry, you broke, or you can't pay for this, or you can't pay for that. It's a shame that, you know, you got a man stand up in the house with you, and he healthy, and he can't help out, because what does Sydney do but sit up there and try to manage Monique's affairs? He doesn't do anything. And, you know, a lot of you women, you know, you feel comfortable with that, because if you get a man that's outgoing, that's confident or whatever, you know, you're teaching the kids against him, and, you know, you feel so challenged by him, you can't even live with him. And, you know, and if he treat you good or whatever, you don't like him. So the Reaper keep it 1,000. So a lot of you got Sydneys out there, you know, just people that you can control and manipulate and manage, and you think they the best thing, you know, to you, you know, since sliced bread, or you make them feel that way, and they're not doing anything, you know. The Reaper keep it 1,000. They wouldn't take you across the street to the grocery store or take you to dinner or anything if you didn't pay for it. The Reaper keep it 1,000. So, you know, but this is what you get, and a lot of you women got a Sydney at home. I'm gonna start saying a Sydney, and then, you know, you want to say cry about your bills and everything. But I think the IRS is coming after Monique is because, you know, she's trying to sue, you know, Netflix and everything else. And, you know, the IRS is a business too. And, you know, hey, they want their money. And, you know, they be in with some of these corporations and stuff. So now you hear Monique all of a sudden in the news for $12,000. And most stuff will be coming out because she's trying to sue a big conglomerate. The Reaper keep it 1,000. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to NCAA hoop star Kamaya Street.
Is that a man or a woman?
A woman.
Okay.
Not only did she admit to being a part of a murder, but officials say they have video of the basketball star during the homicide. The Atlanta police identified her by reviewing surveillance video during the homicide. She admitted to her presence and participation in the death of Hubert Etienne. An investigation of the shooting involving his death. She was indicted for felony murder. The victim was found with a gunshot wound to the groin area. Cops believe the victim was targeted.
You know, a lot of these women is more violent than men, and they, you know, women is emotional, and sometimes, you know, they're more violent than men are. The Reaper keep it 1,000, because a lot of you women, you know, you have trouble holding your temper or whatever, and you be provoking fights and stuff like that, you know, or whatever. But this woman, just like Amber Geiger or whatever, you know, if you look where she shot him at his dick, the Reaper. He had a gunshot wound to the groin. Sometimes that penis be so good, you know, it'll drive a woman crazy. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Because, hey, so you're throwing it on her too good, and you give somebody else some, and she go crazy. Because just like, you know, Amber Geiger did Boda Jean, you know, the police woman. She shot him in his dick, and this was an NCAA basketball player, and, you know, the brother must have been giving her some good penis. And, you know, she found out he was giving it to somebody else and shot him in his dick. She couldn't control it emotionally. The Reaper keep it 1,000. So, you know, let that be a lesson to you. Know who you with. I know he probably figured this woman was going to the WNBA. She had a lot of things in front of her or whatever, just like Amber Geiger did. She was a police officer, but you get the stroke in that too good, you know, and, you know, Aaliyah told you, baby, I like your stroke. You get the stroking it too good. Stroke it for me, you know, and you get the stroking it too good, and some of these women just can't handle it, and their emotions get the best of them, and, you know, and they will become violent. The Reaper keep it 1,000. That's why some of you niggas ain't got no windows in your car, or, you know, she show up at your girlfriend's house or your job or whatever, because, you know, she cannot control herself because she likes your stroke. So make sure you do your interview process correctly, and if you see any violence or a violent streak in somebody, or somebody can't handle themselves, make sure you get up out of that relationship, because it could be detrimental to you, even if you're a man. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to a black hockey player named Akeem Aliyu.
Akeem Aliyu, okay, a black hockey player.
He accuses Coach Bill Peters of racial insults. He allegedly walked in before a pregame skate and said, "Hey, Akeem, I'm sick of you playing that nigga shit." He said, "I'm sick of hearing this nigga fucking niggas in the ass." He walked out like nothing happened. The Calgary GM says they have not fired Peters over the allegations yet. The NHL launched an investigation and found out he called a black player a nigger while managing a minor league team 10 years ago. The NHL says his behavior is unacceptable, and Akeem says he dropped the N-word several times before.
And they still ain't fired him. See, you know, that's what I'm talking about. You know, all of this unfairness. But I bet you if he said something about a gay person, he would have been gone. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Or about a woman, you know, if he would have made sexual remarks about a woman, or he would have made sexual, you know, remarks about somebody that was gay, he would have been gone. But they say they don't discriminate against race or, you know, sexuality or whatever. But, you know, when it comes to race, you know, when somebody speaks out of turn or does something racist or whatever, you know, they always cover it up, or that person gets a pass. And this is the problem that we have, you know, with racism and unfairness, because it should be addressed, you know, just like, you know, if you said something sexual to somebody or whatever, but it's not, because a lot of these, you know, people that's racist or whatever, you know, they have no compassion, you know, for black people. And it's just that they're jealous. That's what it is. You know, this coach is jealous of black people. You know, don't hate me because you ain't me. And that's why he's using racial slogans or whatever, you know, because he's jealous of black people. Because what, why would he be using this, you know, with black players or whatever, if he was not jealous? You know, I mean, you know, I mean, they used to talk about, you know, Bo Derek or whatever, you know, and Bo Derek, you know, she was a 10 when they used to talk about braids in your hair. But Bo Derek was a 10. And then they used to talk about, you know, lips and butts and everything else. But everybody is trying to have plastic surgery to get lips and butts. Hold on. Yeah, that was somebody ringing the doorbell. But anyway, the Reaper said, you know, they was trying to get lips and butts and everything else. And, you know, they was talking against that. So, you know, racism is a terrible thing. I hope this coach get fired, and I hope he never gets another job. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Jeremy Meeks.
Jeremy Meeks.
He's being sued by WeHo Auto Rental Incorporated along with Terry Joe Baby Jr., the same man he was busted with when he became a hot mugshot guy. He rented a 2016 Porsche Cayenne and a 2019 Mercedes-Benz in September, and both cars were involved in separate car accidents. The rental company claims one accident occurred on September 5th and the other on September 10th. Here's where it gets more interesting. Cops in Stockton meet says Meeks was arrested on felony weapons charge in 2014 with the same guy. That's where Meeks got popular off of his mugshot and married the heiress, Chloe Green, but Bailey didn't get the same kind of fame, and they feel that he was using these accidents to have a second chance at fame.
Yeah, well, you know, people always use things to have a second chance at fame. You know, Jussie Smollett, you know, was using that, you know, because he was a homosexual man and he was a black man or whatever, you know, he was using that to, you know, catapult his fame. And some people will use, you know, different things, you know, sympathy things to try to get, you know, fame and fortune and everything else. You know, we see it with the women in the R. Kelly trial and Bill Cosby thing. You know, they're using stuff to try to get, you know, fortune and fame. And this man is no different. He's using the same thing. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Miami Dolphins player named Mark Walton.
Mark Walton.
He was arrested for punching a woman in the face and head several times who was pregnant with his child. She's 5 weeks pregnant and just told him 2 days prior her eye is swollen. Charges against him include aggravated battery against a pregnant woman, which is second-degree felony that carries a maximum of 15 years. Walton clearly has issues. He had 4-game suspensions and 3 prior arrests. One happened where police had to tase him following a high-speed chase in a BMW. He's been cut from the Miami Dolphins.
Yeah, well, he should have been cut long time ago. You know, I remember when Chad Ochocinco, which is Chad Johnson, got into one altercation in his whole lifetime. And that was with Evelyn Lozada, and we could see that she's violent on TV, right? She's violent on TV and everything else, and you can tell that she's got an anger problem, you know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. But they got into it or whatever, and, you know, the Miami Dolphins didn't re-sign him, and he only got into it one time with her, and she was, you know, she wasn't pregnant. So this dude should go to jail or whatever, because you shouldn't be beating on a woman, period. And you dang sure shouldn't be beating on a woman when she's pregnant, you know. So that should be some jail time, and, you know, he should never get back in the league. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I don't know how he's been doing this and getting back in the league, you know, anyway. Because, like I said, you know, Chad got into it with his wife one time, and, you know, and his wife is known to, you know, have an anger problem and beat somebody up or throw some glasses at people and everything. And she's known to can't control the temper, but they still did not let Chad come back. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Halle Berry.
Halle Berry.
She's now accusing her ex, Gabriel Aubrey, of having an incest relationship with one of his family members. She also accuses him of racism and emotional abuse. He quit having sex with her 6 months into their relationship. He called her racist names and won't acknowledge any black in their daughter, Nyla. She accuses him of having a history of mental illness and depression, and this is all in the custody of their daughter, which he still has.
Yeah, but that's Halle Berry's fault, you know, because, you know, she should have done her investigation on this dude or whatever, but she wanted to control the purse strings or whatever because this dude wasn't even known. And they always say, just like they said in Nicole Brown Simpson case, she was a model. But Nicole Brown Simpson wasn't a model. She was a housewife drug addict, you know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, just like this Gabrielle dude, he didn't make no significant money modeling or whatever. And you could see that the dude got issues or whatever, you know. But I contend that, you know, when somebody wants to mind control somebody and hold the purse strings up over them or whatever they want to do, or the wallet or whatever, you know, they don't do their investigation. And Halle Berry, you know, because she had some prominent men. She had David Justice, who was a baseball star and, you know, millionaire. And she had Eric Benet, who was a singer, and she just could not get along with them. And it was always the man's fault, the man's fault, the man's fault, you know. and everything else. I think she accused David Justice of, you know, of cheating, and she accused Eric Benet of having a sex addiction, because that's the first time I ever heard of that, you know, a sex addiction or whatever, you know, and then, you know, now she's accusing this cat, and he didn't even have a career like they did or whatever, and he didn't have the money that they had or a career, you know, and now she's going through a divorce because the judge has ordered her, you know, go figure this, the judge has ordered her to pay his freight, you know, and this cat, and she's accusing him that, you know, he's racist and saying their daughter is this, their daughter is that. I've heard this before, and she's been going through it with this cat for years because this cat has got part-time custody, you know, of the child, and he can't even afford to take care of the child. When do you hear this, you know? You know, but, you know, the Reaper say that, you know, it's racism in that because he's a white dude. The Reaper keep it 1,000 because when do you hear when this dude has never been married to Halle Berry? He has a child by Halle Berry, but he was granted part-time custody and he has no career. And she's got to pay him for his part-time custody, and she's had no abuse things or whatever. So I think the whole thing, you know, is mixed up and there's some racism in it, you know, even with the system of it, but, you know, and this is why Halle Berry is accusing him of racism or whatever, or this, that, and the other. Now, she didn't do her investigation, and I, you know, the allegations of incest or whatever, you know, she would have to prove them or whatever, but, you know, some people will do anything. The Reaper keep it 1,000. What else she got?
That's the end of our stories,
and we would like you to subscribe to the Reaper. Because we're doing good things here at Reaper, and we would like to thank Sweet and Sassy for her trending topics. She does do a good job. And make sure, you know, that, you know, you do your investigation on things or whatever, because mind control, you know, people use it to control other people. And just make sure you're not one of those people that's caught up in, you know, mind control. Reaper, we keep it rough, we keep it raw, we keep it real. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper, because we doing good things here at Reaper. And make sure you thumbs it up and share it with a friend. Enjoy your holiday. Reaper out. Peace.